To host an Olympic Games, safe, efficient, reliable, and on-time transport for all game stakeholders, each with very specific requirements, needs to be provided. Venue Transport defines the transport operations at competition, training, and non-competition venues. But it's not just about turning up on the day and dropping off stakeholders or finding a place to park.
The Venue Transport team do a lot of planning and a lot of rehearsals to understand how the vehicles will move in and around a venue. But then on the day, they need to adapt to the reality of what occurs, and they need to be able to ensure that all the stakeholders can get there.
Every organising committee will have limitations with the space they have within and around the venues. It's all about understanding the space you have, looking at both the front of house and the back of house, and delivering efficient and innovative solutions.
Understanding the clients, understanding what you need and what you want to deliver, you will start to plan the ingress and the egress for each one. With that, you need to cross with all the pedestrian routes, all the other clients, and especially the residents. You need to track each aspect of that operation, because as soon as come live, if you don't know exactly gonna happen, it will be pretty hard to change.
For the new venues and new transport hubs, that's the challenge. You have to work very hard with the city to identify the constraints, every single corner, the signage around the venue, the parking for your clients, and also the flow for the pedestrian in general, volunteers, staff, contractors, and spectators, especially in the last mile.
The importance of maps and tools can't be underestimated. Rio 2016 established an innovative way to share information and plan with the city, delivery partners, and stakeholders.
9% of the meetings were inside of the room. Because we have now Google Earth, we have a free tool that we could share information, we can plan, we can look to each detail of the operation. And it's not a map, it's not a drawing, it's a satellite photo that we can make a zoom in and see like where's the pole exactly that we're gonna put the signage.
Once you have the plan, training, signage, and communication are key success factors in ensuring the plan can become operational.
Don't underestimate how important signage is. It doesn't matter if you have a great Olympic lane plan, a great access plan. It's all about the driver's behavior and the pedestrian behavior. If you don't plan your signage, so you're lost.
One of the biggest transport operations for the Games are the opening and closing ceremonies, with up to 700 buses all arriving on venue in a short time frame and departing in an even shorter time frame.
We needed to understand which service levels we were going to keep, how we would keep servicing clients while doing the ceremonies. Another thing was actually talking and planning with all of our services and the venue itself. It became everybody's plan. It wasn't only our plan.
It can be much more challenging in a winter games. You have to consider a lot of driving conditions, roads that are at a steeper incline. You have to consider snow on the roads and weather conditions.
Vehicle access and or parking permits, the VAP scheme, is the mechanism that controls all vehicle access to the Olympic route network and venues.
You need to understand your clients. You need to understand how much space do you have. You need to understand the venues. And you need to establish the procedures in order to understand how you're going to produce all the permits and how you're going to distribute among the clients. So the VAP team needs to work together always with the venue team.
Once you go live, it's the people on the ground who keep it moving. This is when the planning becomes an operation. On the day, it's being able to manage whatever turns up.
Great people on those load zones that can identify issues and can use the resources that are available to move people where they need to be is critical. The team need to be empowered and enabled to do that on the ground.
The final ingredient for keeping people moving during the Olympic Games lies in the ability to integrate and coordinate with the city transport operations. This is where the city's center of operations plays a leading role. It's able to look at the geography of the city and potentially close roads or control traffic lights in the quest to help move people around the city and into the venues.
For us to be able to monitor and to operate Olympic Games, we were sure enough that we needed to organize ourselves into regions. Each table that you see there, they are monitoring one single region of the city. And then we have social media monitoring. We have our minute-by-minute scheduling boss there, who needs to be knowing everything each time, what's happening.
So, in summary, work with the city to identify the constraints and flow of traffic. Understand the space you have and the services you need to deliver. Integrate your transport team with the City Operations Center. Ensure you have a strong signage plan with the ability to make on-the-ground adjustments supported by stakeholder communications and training. Plan and deliver the vehicle permit scheme. And once you go live, it's the people on the ground who keep it moving.